We all remember the hype behind 2011's psychological thriller, The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. And now the story continues with the latest installment.
Yeah, James, the popular franchise is getting a highly anticipated sequel with the new crime thriller, The Girl in the Spider's Web. Arthur Cade recently caught up with director Fede Alvarez, Claire Foy, and the rest of the cast for a closer look.
Why is it this bad? Why is it spiders don't get stuck in their own webs?
Elizabeth Sander is back,
yes.
And Claire Foy. What an actress.
Fantastic. She's definitely one of the best actors working today. And I mean, for a director, that's the best privilege you can get to work with someone like her.
I was really excited to do it, really. I've always loved the books. I've always loved the character. And so, and I met Fede, and he had such an exciting idea for the movie. And I think Elizabeth is one of the most vulnerable and brave people I've ever played. So it's a real honor to play such a complex character.
Why did you help everyone but me?
What's everybody getting with The Girl in the Spider's Web?
Oh, God, a lot of action. It's fast. There's a lot of different elements to it, but I think what Fede has done so well is just make her a fearless, powerful woman that just doesn't stop fighting.
With everything we're seeing around the world, to have a movie that's led by women, kick-ass women, pretty important messaging, isn't it?
Well, yeah. I mean, how many really great, cool action thrillers do you know with women leading it? I mean, there aren't many. So I think we need that.
There's been other movies, but there hasn't been one where she's the center, where it's all about Lisbeth Salander. The other story is about the journalist Mikael Blomqvist, and she's a part of it, but this time is the first time that it's a movie that is 100% about her. I think that was about time.
Now the world will burn, and everyone will know. It was you who lit the match.
You can catch The Girl in the Spider's Web in theaters now.